What is the minimum spec graphics card for Star Citizen? That's what this video is about. Let's get into it. Over the last few months, I've tested lots of graphics cards to find a new champ, basically, to find something to replace the 1060 6GB, which is showing its age a little bit. So, in this video, I've taken some of the best contenders from the testing that I've done, and then I've popped them in the minimum spec system. So, the minimum spec system has got the i5-8400, which is my recommended bare minimum to get in Star Citizen on the CPU side, on Intel side. On AMD, it's between the 2600 and the 3600. One of those two would probably be a comparison. And then we've got 16GB of RAM running nice and slowly, 2400MHz, I think this is running at. And so, this is a bit of a test to see if you put these graphics cards in with a comparable CPU and RAM setup, how do they perform? And then at the end of this, we should be able to recommend what you should buy, or at least if you're looking to try the game out, what you should get as a bare minimum to try and get half decent frames. Because as we always say, Star Citizen is not like most games. If you're expecting a minimum spec to get you 60 FPS at low settings, forget it. You're going to be more likely to get 30 FPS with definite dips below 30 in the cities. So, just have that in mind. If you're trying the game out for the first time, or you're thinking, why isn't my PC running very well? It is because Star Citizen is a bit of a monster. CPU really loves really fast CPUs. And so, if you want to get really good frames in this game, you've got to go out and buy a 5800 X3D or something like that on the AMD side, or the newest Alder Lake CPUs. It really is a very CPU demanding game, and actually we're finding that it's becoming more and more GPU demanding as time goes by. So that's enough of that. Let's get into some testing and see how these graphics cards perform. Let's start off with Orizon, which is a very GPU demanding scene because you're looking out across the clouds, but actually Orizon is also very intense on the CPU. You'll see here these results are in a bit of a weird order. You wouldn't expect this order, and this wasn't what we saw when we were testing all of these with the 5800X3D. We see that, for some reason, the 1070 is at the bottom, which doesn't really make any sense, and the 1660 base model is at the top, which again, doesn't make much sense. What's going on here is that we are CPU limited in every case, apart from the 1060 6GB. And the problem with this testing here is that all of these cards are just at the whims almost of the CPU doing different work and loading different things in and doing all sorts of things. So it's just thrown everything out of order slightly. What we can really take from this is that we are CPU bottlenecked on the main part in Orizon, and this is a sort of performance you'll expect from the CPU actually, rather than the GPUs. All the three GPUs that we're testing really here today, the 1660, the 1660 Ti and the 1070, have got more room to go at 1080p with the clouds on medium. In space, you'll see all of these cards perform really well. Nothing really to complain about here. You take any of those results, so let's move on. Next, into quantum travel, and this is a nice test because we've got all of these results being GPU bottlenecks. Quantum travel is actually quite hard to run, and so you see the true potential of these cards in quantum travel. That 1660 result, 40 FPS, I'd say for minimum, is great, but the DDR6 that the Ti version has seems to really help in this case. But yeah, any of those newer three cards that we're testing, you'd be very happy with those. Let's look at Area 18 and a CPU bound result. This particular scene, looking at the globe and all the things going on around it, is really heavy on the CPU. As you actually move around Area 18 and you just travel and move around the city, it isn't this bad. So this is a worst case scenario really as you travel through Area 18, but there's not much we can draw from the graphics cards here other than the fact that really the main three that we're looking at today are capable of performing around the 30 FPS mark, which again is what we're kind of aiming for here. Finally, let's have a look at Lawville. This is where I do the majority of the testing, lots and lots of runs to get relatively accurate data. We will see here that the 1070, as expected with this result, sits on top, and the 1660 Ti is below, and the 1660 is below that. But they're all good, around the 30 FPS mark. What we'll say from here is that in the testing we did before on the main system with the faster CPU, we saw big frame drops from most of the 6GB cards and 4GB cards. And so we found that the 1070 actually performed a bit better, and it is slightly ahead still here. But what seems to be happening here is because the overall kind of highs of these runs are reduced by the fact that the CPU is much less powerful, it seems like the drops that the 6GB cards, and they do still have them, because of swapping in memory in and out. We've done some testing on that before, but they do have the drops, but it doesn't seem to affect the overall result as much because the frames never get as high, if that makes any sense, because we're limited by the CPU. All of these results, again, are CPU bound, and so you would see better with the better CPU, but this kind of is our worst case scenario in the game, in the cities doing runs like this, and all of them, I would say, are Star Citizen playable, which means they wouldn't be acceptable in any other game, but for Star Citizen to hit around the 30fps mark, and there will be bits we drop below, they're all pretty good. So, let's try and sum up these months worth of testing and hundreds of pounds worth of graphics cards that I've been buying. We have found, I think, that any of these cards will do the job. The 1070, I think, probably is the best case because it's got extra VRAM, it's got 8 GB of VRAM, and we found in the past that that means it doesn't stutter as much. The 6 GB cards, they swap in some memory in and out, and that does lead to frame drops and a bit of stuttering, whereas actually with the extra VRAM, the 1070 is just a more stable performance, even if it actually probably isn't quite as fast as the 1660 Ti, especially in some areas. But all of the 1660 variants, I would say, are a good starting point for a bare minimum spec. The bottom level, the 1660, the 1660 Super that we didn't test today, which kind of sits in between, and then the 1660 Ti. They're all good graphics cards for Star Citizen to get started. As long as you've got a fast enough CPU, you'll be able to get in the game, see what's going on, and make a judgment for yourself. Anything lower than these cards, I think you are going to struggle in parts. You will be probably okay in space. Even actually the 1060 6GB, if you were to stick out of the cities or if you were to turn the clouds off, you would probably still be able to get around. But I think for trying to get a general sense, a real sense of the game, you'd probably want these other cards that we're talking about. So there we go. This is obviously drastically different from what CIG recommends. And for a long time now, I've been saying that CIG's minimum spec are plainly wrong. And there was talk actually that they were doing some updating, or they were looking at the minimum spec a bit more, but we've not seen anything yet. So far, forget what CIG are saying and listen to me. I've done this testing and I think, yeah, these are the cards to go for. So there's no point, I don't think, recommending one in particular one because they perform so closely in performance. They're all relatively close, but I think any of these ones will do. And so there we go. That is the end of this video. If you like this more technical look at Star Citizen, please subscribe and like, and let me know how you get on with these cards if you've got them. I think a lot of you guys already have been commenting below and giving me good insights to how you found these using these cards. But I'll see you soon. Bye.